Now it's jazz. The place is roaring. All beautiful girls in there. One mad brunette at the bar, drunk with her boys. One strange chick I remember from somewhere, wearing a simple skirt with pockets, her hands in there. Short haircut, slouched, talking to everybody. Up and down the stairs they come. The bartenders are the regular band of Jack and the heavenly drummer who looks up in the sky with blue eyes, with a beard. He's wailing beer caps of bottles and jamming at the cash register, and everything is going to the beat. It's the beat generation. It's Bayat. It's the beat to keep. It's the beat of the heart. It's being beat and down in the world and like old-time lowdown. And like in ancient civilizations, the slave boatmen rowing galleys to a beat. And servants spinning pottery to a beat. The faces. There's no face to compare with Jack Mingers, who's up on the bandstand now with a colored trumpeter who outblows him wild and dizzy, but Jack's face overlooking all the heads and smoke. He has a face that looks like everybody you've ever known and seen on the street in your time. Sweet face. Hard to describe. Sad eyes, cruel lips, expectant gleam, swaying to the beat, tall, majestical. Waiting in front of the drugstore. A face like Hunky's in New York. Hunky, whom you'll see on Times Square, somnolent and alert, sad, sweet, dark, holy. Just out of jail, martyred, tortured by sidewalks, starved for sex and companionship, open to anything, ready to introduce a new world with a shrug. The colored big tenor with the big tone is blowing sunny stits clear out of Kansas City roadhouses. Clear, heavy, somewhat dull and unmusical ideas which nevertheless never leave the music. Always there, always far out. The harmony too complicated for the motley bums of music understanding in there. But the musicians here. The drummer is a sensational 12-year-old Negro boy who's not allowed to drink, but can play. Tremendous, a little lithe, childlike Miles Davis kid, like early Fats Navarro fans you used to see in Espan, Harlem, hep, small. He thunders at the drums with a beat which is described to me by a near-standing connoisseur with beret as a fabulous beat. On piano is Blondie Bill, good enough to drive any group. Now Jack Minger blows out and over his head with these angels from Fillmore. I dig him. Now he's terrific. I just stand in the outside hall against the wall. No beer necessary, with collections of in-and-out listeners, with Bernie, and now here returns Bob Berman, who is a kid from West Indies, who barged into my party 6 months earlier with Dean and the gang, and I had a Chet Baker record on, and we hoofed it at each other in the room. Tremendous. The perfect grace of his dancing, casual, like Joe Louis, casually hoofing. He comes now in dancing like that, glad. Everybody looks everywhere. It's a jazz joint and beat generation mad trick. You see someone, hi. Then you look away elsewhere for something, someone else. It's all insane. Then you look back, you look away, around. Everything is coming in from everywhere in the sound of the jazz. Hi, hey, bang, the little drummer takes a solo. San Francisco, San Francisco. You're a muttering bum in a brown beat suit. Can't make a woman on a rainy corner. Broken plastic coverlets flapping in the rain to cover newspapers all printed up in plain. Guys with big pockets and heavy top coats and slit scar, head bands down, the middle of their hair, all Bruce Barton combed, stand surveying Harrison, Folsom and the ramp, and the red brick clock, wishing they had a woman or some money, honey. Westinghouse elevators are full of pretty girls with classy cans and cute pans and long slim legs and eyes for the boss at a quarter of four. Old age is an Indian with gray hair and a cane in an old coat tapping along the rainy street to see the pretty oranges and the stores on his big day when the dogs let out. Praised be man. He is existing in milk and living in lilies. And his violin music takes place in milk and creamy emptiness. Praised be the unfolded inside petal flesh of tenderest thought. Petrels on the follying wave valleys idly sing themselves asleep.
And who therefore ran through the icy streets obsessed with a sudden flash of the alchemy of the use of the ellipse, the catalog, the meter, and the vibrating plane. Who dreamt and made incarnate gaps in time and space through images juxtaposed, and trapped the archangel of the soul between two visual images, and joined the elemental verbs and set the noun and dash of consciousness together, jumping with sensation of pater omnipotens aeterna deus, to recreate the syntax and measure of poor human prose, and stand before you speechless and intelligent and shaking with shame, rejected yet confessing out the soul, to conform to the rhythm of thought in his naked and endless head, the madman bum, and angel, beat in time, unknown, yet putting down what might be left to say in time come after death, and rose reincarnate in the ghostly clothes of jazz in the gold horn shadow of the band, and blew the suffering of America's naked mind for love into an ailey, ailey, lama, lama, sabak, thani saxophone cry that shivered the city down to the last radio with the absolute heart of the poem of life, butchered out of their own bodies, good to eat 1,000 years. 2. What sphinx of cement and aluminum bashed open their skulls?